A day on Earth is different from a day on other planets. Ever wished for an extra hour or more hours for a day? Your wish has already been fulfilled. The only problem is that those extra hours are not on Earth. Before I go on, let me start with the question. What is a day and what is a year? A day is the time taken for the planet to rotate around its axis, while a year is the time taken for the planet to orbit around the sun. Keep that in mind. So for Earth, it takes 24 hours to complete one giant spin, which is a day for us Earth folks, and it would take 365 days for Earth to orbit around the sun. So if you want only an hour extra to your day, Mars is your best bet, as it takes 25 hours to make a day, but because the distance is further from the sun in comparison to Earth, it takes 686.98 Earth days to make a year. Here is the list for the planets in our solar system and their corresponding time for one day on each planet. From the list, look at Venus. One whole day on Venus would take 243 Earth days. You could say that it is a very long day. But the funny thing about Venus is that, because of the distance of it with the sun, it only takes 224.7 Earth days for Venus to get to a year. So the amazing thing is, the day is longer than a year on Venus. Your weight on Mercury would be much less than your weight on Earth. Well, technically, you would have a different weight on different planets, including any large body in space. This is because of the size of the planets and the gravity of the planet. Don't get me wrong, if you're 50 kilograms here on Earth, you would still be 50 kilograms anywhere else. But what changes is not the mass, but the weight. Because weights are measured in newtons, or in its raw form using the metric units would be kilogram meter per second square. Here is the equation for weight. W equals to mg. M is the mass, which would always be constant, and gravity in different planets would be different, so G would change, meaning W would change. So for example, to calculate your weight on Earth, you would need your mass and the Earth's gravity. The gravity on Earth is a constant, which is measured to be 9.8 meter per second square. Since I don't know your mass, let's use mine. Around 45 kilograms, give or take 3 kilograms, because it goes up and down. Now, plugging the numbers in the equation, my weight would be 441 newtons. Now let's try another planet from the list of gravity I have here. Let's go with Mercury. Mercury has a gravity of 3.6 meter per second squared, so you just have to change the g in the equation to Mercury's to find your weight. With my mass, my weight on Mercury would be 162 newtons, which is definitely significantly lower than on Earth. There is a floating water reservoir in space. Astronomers have discovered the largest water vapor reservoir in the universe back in 2011. Apparently, the discovery of water was not a surprise to astronomers, as it was to be expected, because there's already water vapor in the Milky Way that was found, which was 4,000 times smaller, and it's mostly frozen. But this was definitely the first time water was found very far away from Earth. The reservoir holds 140 trillion times the mass of all the water on Earth's oceans. The water reservoir is currently floating around an ancient quasar, which is more than 12 billion light-years away. A quasar is a massive and extremely remote celestial object, which has one or two black holes in them that emit a large amount of energy. The energy produced from the black hole is what makes the water by literally knocking hydrogen and oxygen atoms together, forming the H2O we all know. So one day, when space exploration is possible and that the crazy amount of distance is navigable, humankind may be able to use that source of water for their advantage for further human multiplication. Though it might not be there anymore, because what people see through a telescope is not in real time. Because of the large distance, it means light that is captured by the telescope would need time to travel from the quasar to the person's eye. This also means that what they saw was something from the past, around 1.6 billion years in the past.